Hello there, very good morning to you. You're watching Proactive London, and Andrew Duxbury is back with us today from Galliford Try. Great to see you again. We're going to be talking about your trading update that you've published this morning. Before we do that, let's maybe get an introduction to the firm for those people who aren't already in the know.
Yeah, morning, Katie. Nice to see you again. So at Galliford Try, we're a UK leading UK construction company. We operate nationally across England, Scotland, building the economic and social infrastructure for the UK. So our core sectors are education, health, justice, water, highways, just to name some of the key sectors. And the UK market at the moment offers real sustainable growth opportunities in all of those core markets and some adjacent sectors that we're looking to move into. I think, Katie, what really sets Galliford Try apart, we're a people-orientated, progressive business. We're a very well-capitalized business. We've got good levels of cash on the balance sheet. We've got no pension fund, we've got no debts. And importantly, we've got a real risk management focused approach. And that helps us assess and manage risks through the business. That's a really core part of our strategy. And our sustainable growth strategy really has four main elements. So the first is its focus on people. Secondly, its focus on socially responsible delivery. Thirdly, a focus on improving quality. And all of that comes together to drive sustainable financial returns for our shareholders, and that drive is about driving controlled margin and revenue growth.
All right, and as I mentioned, you've released your trading update this morning. Let's get stuck in here with some highlights.
Yeah, of course. Well, look, the group is performing really well, both financially and operationally across all areas of our operations. We're making really excellent progress on our sustainable growth strategy that we set out this time last year. And we've announced today that our pre-exceptional profit for the year ended June 2022 will be at the upper end of the range of analysts' forecasts. And our strategy, as I mentioned, is all about sustainable, profitable growth. We're continuing to see good progress with our margin improvement targets through the year just finished. Our balance sheet remains very strong. So as I said earlier, we've got no pension liabilities and no debt. And our average month-end cash position increased during the financial year to £174 million. And it's worth mentioning we achieved that whilst paying 98% of invoices within 60 days. And on average, we pay all of our invoices in 25 days. So really good, strong balance sheet position. The pipeline of opportunities at the moment is really encouraging. So we've got a strong track record focusing on the public and regulated sectors. And that, alongside our strong balance sheet, and that is a real differentiator in this sector, that means that we're really well placed to benefit from the current national investment that's going into economic and social infrastructure. And so you put that together, our order book at the end of June stood at £3.4 billion, slightly higher than this time last year. And we've been really successful in winning a number of framework positions and other contract opportunities during the year. And as I said, we continue to see a really strong pipeline of opportunities coming into the business as well, which are not yet reflected in that order book. And finally, maybe one other thing just to mention, Katie, on Monday of this week, we announced that we'd acquired MCS Control Systems. That's a system integration company and motor control center manufacturer. They're based in Coventry, and their main area of operation is in the water sector. So that's really complementary to our own existing environment business. It's completely aligned to our sustainable growth strategy. And so, yeah, with that, we welcome 81 new colleagues into the Galliford Try family.
We've got to talk about inflation because it is a hot topic at the moment. How have Galliford been mitigating the challenges thrown up by the cost of living crisis and the wider macro environment?
Sure. Well, look, we do continue to see lots of opportunities for work across and for tenders and for new bids across all of our markets at the moment. So the markets are staying really active. So in terms of opportunities, the inflation hasn't dampened that down at all. But I agree, cost inflation has been a feature of the market over probably the last 9 or so months, maybe 12 months. And importantly, we have been able to manage that effectively. And so there's been no overall impact on our trading performance or our financial performance in the period, and we don't see any impact on the targets that we've set for 2023 or through to 2026. So maybe just give you a little bit more color. So we manage inflation across the business in a number of different ways. So firstly, we're very disciplined about the contracts that we take on, making sure that we include appropriate pricing, appropriate allowances for inflation, appropriate risk assessments of all of those contracts. Secondly, we procure materials as early as we can in the contract cycle. What that does is that guarantees availability of those materials, and it also locks in the pricing of that those materials at that early stage of the contract. So that's very important. I think thirdly, we have a really active engagement with our supply chain, and that really has helped us to mitigate the risk, working closely with the supply chain. And of course, as I mentioned earlier, paying the supply chain promptly really helps them want to engage with Galliford Try as well. And I suppose the final thing, maybe just as importantly, the culture of the business means that everybody's focused on risk management, is on managing these kind of risks. And you know, I guess I'd pay tribute to the excellent work that our teams put in, day out, in terms of delivering our projects in these current, you know, more challenging environments. But overall, we've been able to successfully manage and mitigate the impact of inflation across the business.
All right. And let's move on and talk about some of these contract wins then, Andrew.
Yeah, so look, I said we've got this really excellent high-quality order book, £3.4 billion. That's largely in the public and regulated sectors, and those are sectors which are performing really well for us at the moment. And importantly, everything in that order book has come through the tender process and the risk management processes of the business. So everything's come through those strict, disciplined approach to make sure we have contracts that we want to deliver. So it's really high-quality order book. To give a little bit more colour, since January, we've won places on a number of public sector frameworks, and these are an excellent route to market for us in terms of good risk-managed route to market. So one example is the Procure Northwest framework. This is a £1.8 billion framework, and we've won places on 6 lots on that framework in total, 3 lots for our building business and 3 lots for our highways business. In other areas, we've got a really proud track record in education, and we've recently won 2 new schools contracts in Scotland, the Jackton Primary School and the Beatley Campus, and they've got a combined value of around £30 million. And we're also recently were appointed to a £56 million private rented apartment scheme in Milton Keynes. And so you put all that together, as I say, we've got a really high quality order book, and that provides a really great platform for us to move forward and deliver future growth and profitable growth from.
All right, and what about the current outlook and the guidance for the business, Andrew?
Yeah, so look, we see a really positive, confident outlook as we enter the new financial year. We've got the right foundations in place to deliver sustainable growth due to that high quality order book and that strong balance sheet that I've referred to. We continue to prioritise our disciplined approach to bidding and to winning work and that overall focus on risk management. It's all about winning the right contracts that we know that we can deliver profitably for our clients. We've got a strong focus on sustainability, and that's also helping us to win and grow, win work and grow the business, as increasingly our clients are interested in our low carbon construction capabilities. So we're making, put all that together, we're making really strong progress against our strategic objectives, against our financial targets that we've set. We're seeing growth in our margin, we're seeing revenue growth as we enter the new financial year, and we continue to achieve and meet the targets that we set ourselves in that strategy through to 2026. And most importantly, we deliver that because we've got a really excellent team of people right across the country, and they're delivering that strategy day in, day out. So really, this is about paying tribute to the quality of the people right across the business.
All right, we'll leave it there. Andrew, thank you very much indeed, discussing your training update published this morning in plenty of detail from Galliford Try.
Okay, thanks very much, Katie.